So I gave everyone thermometers, went around checking people's temperatures, and also writing information just in a copy book. Essentially what happened was all of the tourists, the white people, tourists, westerners, whatever you want to call them, they were basically shepherded towards all the taxis, all the locals were shepherded towards a bus. Luckily, I managed to make my way amongst the locals and jumped on the bus, had no idea where it was taking me, and basically I have no idea where it's dropped me off, but I'm here in Nova Girona. This island, again, I'll try and include a little bit of information in an email, but this is the island where Fidel and his cohorts were banged up when they were misbehaving a little bit. But yeah, I'll get back to you again. So it's a lovely, quaint little spot here. Absolutely lovely. Space, the Cubans, or maybe that should be the Spanish, I guess. Here I am in another little square in the centre of Nueva Girona, in Isla de Juventud. I've met Ben Lucrecia and two friends of Lucrecia's from Argentina who are also on a boat. Great to see them again, obviously. We'll be heading back to the boat again in the afternoon. Ben had quite a lot of difficulties, and Lucrecia had difficulties whilst I was away. I briefly mentioned the issues with the engine, the sails, the boom, steering, quite a lot of bits and pieces went wrong, and they all went wrong together, unfortunately, but this is sailing, I guess. They got some bad weather and these things just happen. Everything is fixed now, thankfully, and the boat is pretty much ready to go. We just need to load up today with some vegetables. Myself and Ben are going to go alone sailing towards Havana, and we'll meet Lucrecia again into Havana. So we've got to load up with vegetables, we already have fuel, need to get water too, and then we'll be good to go as far as I'm aware. A little quick look around. Like I said in one of the last videos, it's a quaint little spot, this one. There's Lucrecia waving on the phone. It's a quaint little spot, really, really nice little spot here. Much more relaxed, obviously, than Havana, and it's really well designed. And a lot of character. Anyway, I'll see you again soon. Hola.
Hola.
Who's it for? It's not for me, is it?
Hola. It's so hard to work with this.
Huh?
I don't know what to use this for.
Another little spot here for John to recognize. Hiller either side. Above the door, you know what?
Logica la Evangelista.
Absolutely everywhere.
The old lodges.
No getting away from them here. With Ben Lucrecia and the two Argentinian friends, I forget their names. Just on our way to have lunch. It's a bit of grocery shopping here. Not quite Tesco, but we get the job done. Might get a pair of wellies too in case we need them. More supermarket shopping. Thank you. was. Fidel spent some time in back in the day before they were successful with the revolution. Just came here for a quick look. Over the far side there, that's a school. This is kind of a museum, but the whole place is pretty much totally abandoned except for one staff. Setting though. All the bars taken out, yeah. Building. This side, this was used to house all the people, all the rebels, including Fidel Castro, who attacked in Santiago. And on the far side here, this was the hospital and place for the lepers. And
sick people, and the middle building there that you can see, that was where they ate, eating quarters, and the other ones were cells. And unfortunately, the actual museum itself is closed, so we can't see too much, but that was just one of the workers were telling us. Incredible though, really interesting. Never a dull moment. In Cuba.
Hey, Bo, ¿cómo te sientes, Babo?